Let's go through the assignment. In this pane, I've got index.pug, my putative pug file. It's empty at the moment. In this one, expected output.html to refer to. And in this one, index.html, which is going to be generated automatically from index.pug. So, let's start in index.pug, doctype HTML, no exclamation mark. At the same level of indentation, HTML. In a level, head. In another level, the viewport meta tag. Going from HTML to pug syntax where there are attributes is just a mechanical process. So I'm going to do Ctrl-C in the HTML and just copy that and paste it into the pug file. Simply remove the opening angle bracket, add opening parentheses after the name of the tag, no space, meta in this case, and replace the closing angle bracket with a closing parenthesis. So that's the HTML. And this is the pug version. And the same for the CSS link. There's the HTML. And the pug version. On the same level, title. And the title of the page, Acme Cleaning Services, on the same line. By the way, clicking on the left allows one to collapse or expand sections to make it clearer where one's got to. This can be helpful when the file gets bigger and more complicated, so don't forget that. Outer level, so we're at the same level as head. Body. Inner level, to get inside the body area. Div.logo, or just .logo. Inner level, to get inside the logo div. Then the image with an attribute, so it's img for image, and then in parentheses, src equals images, /logo3.png. There are various other beautiful logos for you to choose from. Outer level, to get out of the logo div. Div.topnav or just .topnav. Inner level, ul.topnav-right. And then inside the ul, so a level deeper, li. And then inside that, a link. So it's a, and then in parentheses, href equals news.html. End the parentheses, space, news for the anchor text. Then you can copy and paste the rest of the LIs and the anchor tags that they enclose. Changing the links. Our team, contact, and aboutus.html. Out two levels to get to the same level as TopNav. Main. Inner level to get inside the main section. H2, our services. On the same level as the H2, inside the main element, .sections-grid. Inner level again. Section.section.section1. So this is an HTML5 section element, that's the name of the tag. And it has two classes applied, section, which applies to all of these, and section 1, which is special for this particular one. Inner level again. H3. In another level. An anchor tag. A, and then in parentheses, href equals hash, we're just doing dummy links. Hospitals. And then you can use that and copy and paste the rest of those H3s and their enclosed links. Changing hospitals to hotels, house cleaning, end of tenancy, oven cleaning, and COVID disinfection. And I've just noticed that I made a mistake. The H3s should each be inside a section. So we need to put section.section.section2, section 3, to enclose each of those H3s. Hopefully, soon Acme Cleaning Services won't be offering that last service anymore. Then out, so we're at the same level as the main element. Footer. And then in again. P for paragraph. Copyright symbol, so that's ampersand copy, semicolon, 2020, Acme Cleaning Services Limited. Check that carefully, check the HTML that's been generated, and make sure it matches expected output.html in the way that the elements are nested. And have a look at it in the browser. That was a slightly artificial exercise. We wouldn't normally take an HTML file and rewrite it as a PUG file. And in places, I could probably have made it less complex. I had some levels of nesting which it might have been possible to avoid. But I wanted to give a lot of practice in working out the levels of indentation. Writing PUG by hand like that is okay, but in the next lesson, we'll look at a much easier way to do it. And that's by using emit abbreviations in PUG.